Do this. Just jump in. All right. There are basically no options. Oh, no, I have to pick my car. I don't know what these things mean. We probably want the lighter vehicle, right? I think lighter with wide wheels? I have no clue. 1150 and 25. Goosens. Something tells me it doesn't matter a whole lot. We're going with goose. The goose is loose. Sure. All right, sweet. Default is normal. That fits well. Qualify. Oh, okay. We always want more steering, right? I don't know what's good. And I don't know what any of that other stuff means. I guess we qualify. Ready, set, go. Wow, there are no options. Okay, there we go. Oh my God, is there no music? Oh. Alright, the drifting's interesting. Kinda like it. Oh man, we're definitely gonna have to turn this game audio down. Yeah, no music. Just engine sounds. What were you thinking? Uh-oh. At least there's sort of a course map. Go this way. Oh, that's the pit stop. Which I'm sure we don't have to concern ourselves with. Yeah, this is, I don't know. It's no Diddy Kong Racing. Oh my God, come on, get out of the grass. Alright, so maybe drifting is not as good. it was not good. Yeah, I'm wondering if you need to like change the you're changing the tires. Would help. Okay, that wasn't too bad. That wasn't great. Yeesh. Didn't feel good. All right, we could probably turn this. Eighth poop. I don't know how many rounds there are. No, I forgot to look it up. Oh, damn. Get points. Okay. All right. Just let me. Trying this again. I think we leave everything else. All right. man, my turn. It's better to just go full freaking speed into the wall. Oh no, because then you get stuck in the grass. Oh, 29. And so, so you really just have to break. At least from what I can tell at the moment. Breaking seems to be the way to go. Yeah, one. Alright, that was my best lap. Yep, need to break early there. That was not good. Get out of that slide. Great. Yeah, I don't know what else to do here. Yeah. That was slow. That's so far and last. What the hell? I don't know what any of this crap actually means. Oh baby, finally a game where I can look up a manual. The aim of the champ. Alright. Hello. That was weird. Alright, the aim of championship mode is to win each of the 6 available races. Okay. Sweet. Huh. You can change the computer cars. Battle mode. All right, so you want soft tires. Hurry up and be so we can play Remix. Yeah, man. I still didn't look up how to host. So I'll still have to play on server. I mean, that wasn't bad though. All right, looks like that manual wasn't very helpful. Damn. R.I.P. Chris Kringle, what's up, man? I don't know what to do. Like, I can change the computer teams. Like, whatever. Pringles ad? Chris Pringle. Dude, I don't get... No, because those are pre-roll. Those are pre-roll ads. I don't get any of that. Twitch gets that. I only get ads if I run ads during my stream. Which is, like, pretty freaking useless for me. Considering, you know, there's no one watching. What does gear ratio do? I don't know. Interesting. Aw, thanks, Athens. But yeah, yeah, Twitch is like, oh, look, we're giving affiliates ad revenue. But yeah, it's only the pre-roll stuff doesn't count. So it's like, I would have to run ads during the stream. Which is, like, ridiculous. And then yeah. You know, there aren't that many people watching, so... I get, like, nothing. Ad revenue is pretty whack until you get, like, until your viewers are in the thousands. Then it starts to get legit. That seems like a good intentional wall to hit. We need to do better. Like, when I streamed SmashCon and I peaked at, like, 7,500 viewers, I don't remember what the average was for the day. That was the peak. And I think I made, like, a couple $100 in ad rev. On, like, that's a partner account. So I was running ads. You know, I was running, like, a few minutes of ads per hour. Yeah, I mean, like, ad rev on Twitch, like, yeah, it's better than nothing. but you're not like making bank unless, yeah, your viewers are in the thousands. Yo, there we go. 118. Is this car just better? Like, that's the thing. When you're picking the cars, all these, like, racing sim games do this. There's, like, a driver and a team, and I don't know what any of this, like, means. Like, how does this translate to good or bad, fast or slow? Like, I don't know, like, the weight of the car and the width of the tires and the type of engine. Like, come on. I need a bar that goes across the screen that's just like fast or slow. Okay. I hit the wall too. That was too much. Alright. That wasn't too bad. If you don't get... Oh, yeah. I don't think a Japanese Netflix is coming. Yeah, this is a little better in Japanese. Yeah, this thing, like, Gyaki and Sekire have done really well when they came over here with Link, despite, like... Oh, hey, Puddle, what's up? Yeah, it's this masterpiece. Oh, so that was my qualifying race? Sorry. That's another thing these racing sims like to do. You have a qualifying race, and then based on how you do in the qualifying race, that's your starting position in the next race. I mean, that's how, like, actual racing works. So that was my qualifier. And based on the qualifier, I actually got pole position. So that's nice. But yeah. So it looks like this one at least is more clear about how I win. It's a circuit style where, like, you get points based on where you place. Yeah. Boost. Whoa. No, get out of the ground. No. Oh, man. That was a bad spot to hit. I could change it so that I only have one qualifying lap instead of three. Actually, it would be two. So one of them, it's like you get a practice lap. And then, damn it. You get a practice lap, and then your next lap is your time. So it's like that one lap is the only one you get to use. As opposed to what I just did, where you do three laps, and the best of the three is, you know, your qualifier. Oh, that was a lot easier. Thank you. so far ahead. No, why? Why do I... Yeah, you know, like, this game has, like a theme song. Like, there's menu music. And there's music on the title screen. But then, there's nothing in the actual game. I think it was F1 World Grand Prix did the same thing. It had, you know, a theme song and menu music, and then nothing. Damn. I really went and got last. No. What's up, Baconator? Coro Q? Wow. Oh, and the car I switched off of got first. Oh, dude, it's so loud. They had the Grand Prix in Baltimore for like 2 years, and I lived nowhere near it, and I could still hear it from my house. It was kind of crazy. Seeing where some of the turns are. I can't tell if running into the walls are all that bad. Boom. Yeah, I don't see much of a downside. Just slamming into that wall. Or that one. I might as well just go full speed. I think. Pit stop. 109. That was a lot faster. I'm driving like Shears. Ah, come on, Shears doesn't just hit stuff. Except for deer. He has hit deer. So, fun story, I actually, this is years ago, I was teaching driver's ed at the time. I taught driver's ed for like 6 years, in case you didn't know. So we had just been out at the bar to like play video games and stuff, like we did every Wednesday. And I've been home for a bit, and then I get a phone call, and it's Dave. And he says he needs me to come pick him up because he got pulled over. And they won't give him a ticket for drunk driving if I go and pick him up and take him home. So I went and picked him up in the freaking driver's ed car. Oh, man. Yeah, Dave's kind of crazy. Oh, damn, they're all really slow. Might actually be able to win this one. Yeah, he's definitely lucky to have me. I mean, obviously, he's super lucky to have me. But in that instance, he would. My kind of course. Need more courses like this one. But yeah, when the Grand Prix was in Baltimore, it was super loud. Also, one thing I don't like about playing when I have to play racing games on stream is it's like really hard to talk to you guys in chat because I can't like look away while I'm racing, you know? So that's pretty lame. I'm so far ahead of them. I say that, but I'm gonna like hit a wall and it's gonna turn me around and I'm gonna be facing backwards or something, and then I'm gonna lose. The people, you know, this game, you see all the people standing on the sides. Like, it's actually like that. Like, people are like right next to the track, and it's kind of terrifying. Consistent. 2-1-12s. I just have to look down, yeah. Yeah, IRL streamers drive around in real life in WeChat. I would have more faith in myself driving around in real life and reading chat, because I wouldn't be driving fast like this. I'm in much more control in a real car than this thing. Also, I just realized I switched from D-pad to joystick without even thinking about it. You can use either one in this game. Take that, Moosh. D-pad game. I was slower this time, because I didn't care. Oh, yeah, Dale Earnhardt's Seatbelt. That's probably not the best name for a song. You were really bummed and nobody crashed. What a jerk. Yeah, I won. Oh, but they got 4 points. Oh, yeah, getting zero kind of hurt. I think there's only 6 tracks. This does not look good. Is not my kind of track. Very blocky. Oh, hey, Peach. Oh yeah, so I gotta get in a few streams this week because I'm about to be gone for a whole week. I'm not gonna be able to stream or anything. I'm like not gonna have internet. Holy crap. That was something. That wasn't so bad. Ooh. I thought the corner was a little different. Couldn't cut over fast enough. Go. At least this game has a sort of course map. I really don't like it when a racing game doesn't at least have the option to turn one on. It's so nice having them. So I've said this a bunch, but like, all these racing games I'm playing, I mean, most of them I'm playing for the first time. So not having a course map is brutal. Because, like, not only do I have to, like, get good at the game, but I have to learn all these courses. Like, even if you're not very good at a racing game, if you at least know the road, then you'll be better. Oops. Thank you. Drifting is the art of maintaining control while losing it all at once. While losing all control. I don't remember, man. I think I saw Tokyo Drift one time, and that was when it came out. There was much of it that I do not recall. How did I do? Oh yeah, first. Rolling start. Alright, let's burn these noobs. Yeah, I guess, like, I don't know, maybe the computers just, like, slow down a lot more for the turns. I don't know, there are just too many turns on that first course. Oh, no, you know what? I got clipped by that wall on the first course, and it put me really, that, like, really hurt me. Oh, and the grass. There was grass. This one I can just run into the walls. And yeah, they don't go nearly as fast. On the straightaway. All right, it's decent. Not my best time. But yeah, I think I prefer joystick to D-pad for racing games. Just feels like you have more control. You can make more precise movements. Do I have rules for difficulty? Yes. So my self-imposed rule for game difficulties is I beat the game on whatever the default difficulty is. Whatever it defaults to. If it, like, some games default to easy, I play them on easy. Some default to normal, I play them on normal. I don't think no game has defaulted to hard, so. There's that, but sometimes there's, like, four difficulties, and the default is, like, the third highest. I feel like that's happened a couple times. But I don't think any game has defaulted to the hardest difficulty. Now, one thing that... So, I play the games on the default difficulty. That does not mean I'll beat them on the default setting. So, I try not to do this with fighting games. Like, change it from a best of three to best of one. To make it go faster. But like sports games, you can change like the quarter length and that kind of stuff, and that, in my opinion, is acceptable. But I haven't done that a whole lot. Or like some of the sports games might have like an arcade mode and like a simulation mode, and sometimes I'll play it on arcade mode. Like, it just depends. But the difficulty, I have not wavered from that. There have been two or three games where I played it on a harder difficulty just because I chose to. But... Oh, Killer Instinct Gold? I love it, dude. I grew up playing that game at a, with a friend of mine. So I'm a big fan. I'm not, like, super into it where, like, I'm good with all the characters. I just play Glacius. But, like, I've beaten everybody I've ever played. Oh, man, that guy's tied. Come on. Back off. Everyone else sucks. Yeah, Glacius is dirty. if you talk to some of the Smash guys, know my like challenge that I'll do at tournaments is I'll bet someone that I can beat them in Killer Instinct without looking at the TV, and I'll pick Glacius. All right, so there's another course with grass. Wait, could I have cut across that? Yeah, dude, I think Killer Instinct Gold is the second best. Well, so if you ignore Smash, the best fighting game on the console is Mortal Kombat Trilogy, and then I think Killer Instinct Gold is the second best. And I don't even think it's close. Like, those two are so much better than everything else. There are some decent ones after that, though, like... Fighter's Destiny and Flying Dragon. I haven't played Fighter's Destiny 2 yet. I imagine that's good. Mace the Dark Age isn't horrible. Clay Fighter is not. I wish Clay Fighter was better. Because that's Killer Instinct. Clay Fighter is made on the Killer Instinct engine. So, like, the combo system is the same. The game just isn't good. Oh wait, it's the same course. I've already played this one. It's just a different route. Ah, that's interesting. Okay. So is that I play three courses, but I play each twice. And it's different. Okay. I bet that's what's happening here. It just throws me off because it looks like I'm supposed to go right there, but the course map obviously doesn't tell me to do that. Oh, Glacius is like being a Pika main? Yeah, it kind of is. Or is it Kirby? Because I don't think Glacius is actually the best character in the game. I think he's a noob killer. I feel like, I don't know who the best in the game is. I've never seen a tier list. Laps are a lot longer. First time I played this course, the winning laps were like 118 and 119. Alright, big difference. Yeah, beating people with Glacius without looking at the TV is never gonna get old. That will always be funny to me. I mean, he has a freaking teleport, so yeah. He needs to look at a TV. It is funny when they, like, start to figure it out, though. And then I'll just, like, fireball spam. Man, I, like, panic there, and somehow... I didn't totally fall apart. No. I hate that spot. Because, like, if I clip that tunnel wall, the rebound, like, puts me in a horrible position right there, and I can clip that wall coming out. Such a waste of time. Damn, that was slower than the other two? Damn. Okay. A good time, apparently. Round four. Dude, what am I doing? What is wrong with you? That turn is just so brutal. Who do you play, Adams? In Killer Instinct. The friend I grew up playing this with always he played Jago and Fulgore. I only played Glacius. The best players I've played against were Orchid and Saberwolf players. I'm trying to remember who it was at Inkafest. Maybe it was Abuela? One or the other. He destroyed me in Mortal Kombat Trilogy. I mean, that he's like legit good. He can like play every character. Not like Y-Bomb, who's like pretty good. And we could trade games. This guy I had no chance. I could beat him in Killer Instinct. But I'd probably say he's a better player. If that makes any sense. It's a shame that the the last Killer Instinct game to come out was Xbox only. Like, man, talk about a way to kill a fighting game. Make it Xbox only. Oh crap, we didn't catch him up to me. See, that's like how I need to hit that section to like really pull ahead of the computers. Because they will not just like cut through the grass like I will. Forgot everything I learned in my qualifier. Except for this time. That freaking turn, man. I guess I had a good lap. Kind of pulled ahead. Yeah. Wreck those nerds. Oh yeah.
Finish.
Yeah, the last lap is 4 seconds faster. Three seconds. 3.2. Oh my god, they got last. Yes. Oh, that's exactly what we needed. Oh, that makes life so much better now. Hell yeah. Clutchness. Tells me this one's not going to be quite as easy as last time. Oh, there's just a wall there. Okay. I was like looking at the mini map. I'm like, this doesn't make sense. At least it's not like other racing games where there's like traffic. So I'm racing all these other cars, but then I also am worried about, like, cars going the opposite direction and stuff. That's pretty annoying. I could get a good, if I had like a really good first lap, if I could just end. Yeah, that messed me up bad last time. Seven seconds faster. That's pretty silly. Oh no. Oh no. Flipping that wall is not what you want to happen. Something tells me I'll be using my lap 2 time. Not even close. Hitting that wall was real bad. Alright. Still first. If I get first in this one, then I don't even have to race the next race. So that's pretty crucial. That's what we play for. We play so that we don't have to play more. Play as little as possible. That's a rough one. It seem like they're close. Yeah, we definitely are. We hear them. Yep. Get out of here. Gotta drive full speed. I don't know why I was trying to actually make that turn. So much better to just run over the wall. Gotta win this one. Then we are home free. Assuming there are only six races, like I was led to believe. Holy crap, that was so much faster. I like forgot where I was for a sec. That was bad. Oh yeah. My new strategy of just running into the walls. It's a little too good. That's a tricky one, though. Finish. The goose. Back in it. But they can't catch me now. Yeah, there's only six. Sweet. See if I can catch anyone. I'll do one lap. Yeah, when you start in last, even if you have like better lap times, you have to make up time because they started ahead of you. It's pretty whack. I'll just finish the race. It's only gonna be another 3 minutes. Third, let's go. So funny how I got last in the first race and then first in all the others. The speed boost that guy just got. I did not mean to do that. Yeah, I don't know if I can catch this guy. Might be too much for me. All right. Never mind then. Holy crap, lap two was 9 seconds faster than lap one. That is pretty wild. Oh crap. Yeah, let's go. Look at that. Destruction. Is that it? Congratulations. Woohoo! Easy peasy. That took 1:19:04. That could have been under an hour if I didn't take so long at the beginning. That wasn't bad at all. 3:23. Now it's time for a football game. Sweet. It's so nice when they're easy. I feel like we haven't gotten one of those in a while. Let's look. A nice, quick, easy racing game. No, it's been a long time. Holy crap. Aero Gauge was pretty quick, and that was 23 games ago. Gonna be doing franchise mode? Probably not. So what I do for most of the sports games is I do just like championship mode, or like playoffs, or you know, like whatever they have, instead of doing a full season. The way I look at it, almost all the sports games have the option to simulate games, so I could like just keep pressing and simulate a season. It's just whack. There's like no reason to play a whole season. Unless you're trying to, that's like 100%, you know? Championship though? Playoffs? Postseason? Yeah. All right. Oh, also, how's it going, Croc? Hope all is well. Played a bunch of Madden 2001. Had to simulate a bunch to stay sane. Yeah, that's kind of how it goes, man. It can be a little too much. Game over. All right, we did it.